You know, we're at an interesting point with AI. I'm starting to see some real patterns emerge. The first is the use of virtual agents by an organization. They can be used internally to answer HR questions, for example, or answer legal questions, or maybe IT, and externally as well, answering customer care questions, and in the long term, being a virtual representative on behalf of an organization. The second is this notion of, we think of it as ambient computing, but really tracking people and objects in space. Myself walking up to a building and using face recognition or image recognition to let me in, basically as a security. If we track people and objects, you could imagine a manufacturing facility or a warehouse. I'm walking down one aisle, a forklift is coming down another aisle, making sure that forklift doesn't accidentally run into me. That would be sort of a safety scenario. And the third, which is really a popular area right now in this space, is this notion of tracking people and objects in space and retail. Being able to know who came into the store, being able to pick up items. During that process, maybe able to do real-time couponing. When the person is done, being able to sort of walk out of the store and do automatic checkout. It's not just computer vision, you need to use sensor fusion with other types of tag, be it RFID or NFC, but really that pattern of tracking people and objects in space has some phenomenal scenarios. A third pattern is this notion of AI assisting professionals. It could be helping finance people do forecasting. We can use it with sales to help a sales associate know how to better spend their time over the course of the day, how to make trade-offs between potentially customers that might churn and new customer opportunities that are coming in. It's used in medical for areas like radiomics or genomics, healthcare overall, the legal system. So this notion of AI assisting professionals. And then the last is this notion of autonomous systems. We think a lot of it in terms of vehicles, but you can have an autonomous network and really sort of self-managing of something like the Azure network or the Skype network. There's process automation that can be used. So if I look broadly, there's really four patterns. The use of virtual agents to work on behalf of a company with either employees or customers or partners. The notion of an ambient computing opportunity or taking the physical space and ultimately digitizing it to add AI to physical spaces. The third is AI assisting professionals in the work that they do. And the last is the use of autonomous systems. I think what makes us unique is this nice balance between repeatable intellectual property or patterns with real AI professionals or capabilities to tailor them for an individual customer. In today's world, there's still a shortage of both AI understanding and talent, and that ability to create semi-repeatable or repeatable patterns that can be reused but still tailored for an individual organization is fairly unique. There's very few people in the industry today who are working on solutions. Those that are typically fairly narrow. So for example, if I want to do a virtual agent, let's say for a telco in a particular geography, you know, there are people that can do that. But thinking about telcos and banks and retailers and creating a solution that works across all of them and not having to be custom each time, that's an area where we're trying to find that right balance between completely bespoke and repeatable.